Good morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss a case on Hindu Marriage Act, particularly regarding the divorce under section 13 of the Hindu Marriage Act. Normally, we may have been seeing there are so many cases where the husbands are becoming the victims of harassment or cruelty by the wives. More often than not, certain cases are coming. And of course, in certain cases, the court may accept to grant the divorce, but in certain cases, they don't want and they don't give also. Here, it is one such case where the husband filed a case of cruelty against the wife, but the court declined to grant divorce. Basically, this is the crux of the case. But how and what are the points on which the court discussed, we have to know. That's why I am making this video right in the early morning. Last night only I have seen this case. So you can read this case as Shankar versus Reena. Sri Shankar versus Reena or Raina, R-I-N-A. While disposing the family court appeal number 70/2016. Please remember, this is a matter of 2016. On 10th February 2021, two judges bench of Bombay High Court bench at Nagpur. So, one of them, you are very studio. One is A.S. Chandrukar and the second one is Madam Pushpa V. Ganedi Wala. So, who has given that controversial judgment about the POKSO Act that there should be some physical touch. And of course, incidentally, it was stayed by the Supreme Court. That's why I don't want to discuss that case. Here in this case, they have not granted the divorce, even though the allegations by the appellant is that the wife showed cruelty towards him. Right? If we know the details of the case, or if you know the facts of the case, it will be better to appreciate the same. Now, this happened at Nagpur. So, the husband, Mr. Shankar, he was married to the wife, Reena, on 15/6/2003, as per the rites of the Buddhist. Of course, they practiced the so-called Buddhism. The marriage was held in the presence of the elders in a ceremonious way. Later, they were blessed with a son and daughter. Of course, they have kept their family at Nagpur, but ultimately, on one day, that is, date also has given, I think on 17/1/2012, that is after 6 years, she left the paternal house, that is husband's house, and she did not come back so far. Later, on 13/3/2012, he sent a legal notice, that is, you know, section 19, restitution of conjugal rights, he has sent the notice, but there is no reply from her side. Ultimately, he has filed a case before the family court, which has rejected, and ultimately, now, as an appeal, he has gone before the Bombay High Court. So now, let us discuss the main grounds on which he sought the divorce. Number one, she was not doing any household work. She was not doing any household work properly and used to quarrel with him as well as his mother frequently. So quite frequently she does not attend. That too, she used to wash the clothes, she used to clean the utensils during the dead of night, that is around 12 o'clock or so, whereby it is causing disturbance to the children. But she is not agreeable and she is picking up quarrels with him also. Then she used to visit her parental house without informing him. Once she goes, she will not come back between 15 and 30 days. So she will camp there for about a month or so. And third point is, please remember, she was addicted to chewing tobacco products. And actually due to which a cyst was developed in her stomach, and the appellant has to pay a lot of money for the medical bills. Right, yes, also to do that, it is a very bad habit. Then she was insisting for a separate family, even though he took a family, she did not come. Of course, it's quite common, it's a point not to be discussed at an early stage. And she left the home on that particular date and did not come back. So, therefore, since there was no other go, he filed the petition under section 13 of the Hindu Marriage Act. Right. Now, here, please refer to the defense. Yes, she has appeared and she has filed the defense. The defense advocate, she has brought only one important point. No doubt, she was being harassed by the husband and his father and mother. They used to harass her, they used to use abusive words on her, but she has suffered, but she stayed with him. Even in 2008, he was diagnosed with HIV, that means he was a HIV patient, but still she stayed with him for up to 2012, that means 4 years. So she has suffered, even though she knows that he was a HIV patient. Yes, he said. But he wanted to have the so-called sexual intercourse with her, for which she is not agreeable, and therefore she left the house in the disappointment. That is the main reason. Now, taking the points into consideration, the court observed that there is no uniform standard procedure, so which can be drawn for giving divorce or for not giving divorce. So, mental cruelty is a state of mind. Definitely, you can't express in terms the grief, the anguish, the disappointment, the feeling of these feelings or frustration. Normally, if they stand for a long time, they may lead to cruelty either on other side, maybe husband or maybe the wife. So, please remember, normally, the incidents of chewing tobacco or quarreling with mother-in-law, all these things, they cannot be taken as harassment. They are quite common in a marginal family. So they are normal wear and tear in the married life. This is the word they have used. They are general and omnibus in nature. Therefore, the pleadings are not so grave, and she has been in the family life, even though she knows that he is a HIV patient. She agreed that she has got the habit of chewing tobacco. It's not so dangerous. Suppose if the husband has got the habit of chewing tobacco, what the wife will do? So, keeping all these grounds, discussing all these things, the Honorable High Court also rejected the appeal. That means they have not granted the divorce. So, good case. The points are clearly discussed, and please remember the defense point, the HIV, it has actually stuck the mind of the judge, and she did not give the so-called grant the divorce. Right? Good points. Please remember them. Study the case well and enrich your legal knowledge. Thank you very much.